You can do it.
Alright, 3, 2, 1. Hey guys, welcome back to the video. This is this is song by Queen called I'm So Glad. Ready, 3, 2, 1.
I'm sat in the dark like some hobbit.
Yo guys, I'm hanging at the minute, like the acoustic version, MTV Unplugged, you know, and all that. It's a record number of days since I've washed my hair, looking classy.
1, 2, 3, 4. I was recording, I sent you the video and then I cleared my camera roll and the video went with it. So like it hadn't actually sent because the file no longer existed anyway. After that near suicide moment. This is the song.
And this is the new one. Imagine I already played it for James. Thank you for the nights and those
days in the park. I'm scared for
My name's Ollie, I'm the lead singer and songwriter and guitarist for the Levitation. We've been going for about just over a year now, playing live. In about a week's time we've got our bass gig so far, coming up at the Lev Mill. So it was first me and James. I'd barely been playing guitar a year, but I basically said, does anyone play bass? And the music teacher said, he does, sat behind you. And then me and James started a band. We had another guy on drums initially, but it wasn't really going anywhere. So I started writing more and kind of folded it over the summer. Then when we came back, we kind of got into it and we found Joe. I literally just put on my Snapchat story, does anyone play drums? He responded to it. So we got Joe in the band pretty quickly. And then after only about 2 months of practicing, we played our first show. And it didn't go as badly as 2 months of practice would probably go, usually.
Hi guys, it's the Levitation.
There we are. She Lives in the Space of My Mind was the first song we ever recorded as a band. It's a pretty simple kind of indie pop thing. And it's the same with Days Nights, although I will say the harmony in that one is one of my favourite parts I've ever written. Though I was actually inspired by the Cowsills, a completely pop band, but their song Rain in the Park and Other Things really inspired that. Which, if you've ever seen the film Dumb and Dumber, it does appear in that film. Andrew's Guide itself is a song I just wrote here in my room, like most of them, to be honest. But that one especially kind of came together as an acoustic song. It was only once I'd finished the whole thing, which took about 2 weeks. They all came quite quickly in rapid successions, all the different sections. But as soon as I completed that, I had the vision for exactly how it was going to sound, this really bouncy song with a really different arrangement. I think it really paid off. It's definitely one of the most unique songs that we've done.
So how did the band start?
So basically, I'd met Ollie at some parties before, back in 2020, and he put in his story looking for a drummer, and I was just drumming then. So I popped up, came to mine, we got jamming, and it's just gone from there.
My music teacher introduced me to Ollie, and I felt really bad for him, so I'd like played with him on his surf band Delfino.
Yeah, so it was kind of year 10 to 11, me and Ollie were in the same French class. And so every couple of lessons, he was like, Isaac, I'm learning the guitar. And I was like, yeah, that's cool. And he was like, Isaac, I'm going to start a band. And I was like, okay, yeah, that's nice. So like in my head, it's this, you know, it's this wacky, crazy guy who's like, he's just got his own band now. And like, he's like, do you want to hear some of the music? And he plays me, you know, the riff to She Lives in the Space of My Mind. And I'm like, hang on, that's actually really good.
Well, I guess I'll just escape to that flower world of yellow and green, living life to the rhythm of a town.
My influences are different from like Ollie's, but I think more modern style drumming mixed with 60s riffs and the like make a really good mesh in the music.
Me and her went on a little trip into town. I thought I'd give Herbie the official Ollie Civil tour of the town centre. We went to just look at the level really and get some footage of that. But yeah, it's interesting to see people queuing outside of it and thinking in about 4 days that's going to be, well, for us, I mean, we've seen how many tickets have been sold. Most of the place is packed. It's a 300 capacity venue. And even though we're only supporting, just to be playing in front of that many people really is a privilege. And I think a testament to how far we've come in such a short space of time, and it just feels so good to be, kind of recognised by people other than ourselves that we're having a good time and we're doing something that we really enjoy.
Oh, I feel like that's too close to my face. And a final British album that I would like to include is this one by the Moody Blues. It has the hit Nights in White Satin on it, which is quite, well, very famous, but it's just really impressive. It's like a whole experience. It's not like a lot of pop albums where you feel like you're jumping from song to song. The whole thing kind of carries as a continuous piece, and it kind of changed my perspective a bit, especially with songs like Flower People and the kind of slower stuff. It made me realise that on an album, the slow stuff works best when tied together with other things. It's like a merging of styles or whatever. That's what I think anyway. This is definitely one of my favourite albums I've bought in town. And I'd heard a lot of the songs off of it before, but to hear where they all, you know, how they all fit together. I mean, it's not perfect, but it's very good. And this is kind of, I always think of this as kind of like the American Revolver. It's just such like a combination of different styles and stuff, so yeah, cool.
You got like a most played vinyl? Like
I think I probably
always come back to it.
Yeah, let me think about that one. I think probably this one, to be honest, Do You Believe in Magic? Because it's kind of, it's easy listening, it's nice, it puts you in a good mood, and it's not too long. I don't like albums that are too long. And it's albums like this and the tracks that are kind of within it that inspired songs like 13th Floor and the more kind of bonkers things that we've come out with recently, at least in my opinion. I don't know how the guys would feel about that. That is The Collection, and as well as Crimson Clover by Tommy James and the Shandells. I really like that one. it's the first album I really got into like properly, because I was really into like instrumental surf music. And you'll see on our gig on Saturday, presuming we haven't killed each other or broken down into some kind of depression by then for messing up on stage, when we get to the surf medley, you will hear Masilu, and well, White Flight's not even on this, but the influence of Dick Dale and the Deltones remains strong in my heart and my mind. And yeah, I don't want people's poster as well. But yeah, cool. Well, I was thinking by this time tomorrow we will have just done it, so there's only so much use in worrying about it, but it's not even like worrying at this point, it's just like we just gotta do it, and I'm kind of excited. If anything, I wish we'd done it. I just wanted to get on with it. I'm kind of excited, to be honest. It's been so long since we've played. I'd be lying if I said I wasn't a bit nervous, but but I just realized there's no point in worrying about it. Like, it's so fun. It's like doing what I really enjoy doing for a whole night that we've not done in so long. It'd be great to have the same buzz, because the feeling you get when you come off stage after having done something like that is just so epic. And it's also playing the Ledmore for the first time and playing for some bands that we really rate as well, so it's perfect. And there's people that have paid good money to see us, so we will not disappoint them. So yeah, cool. We're here for an artist loading the Levitation.
Okay, come through, guys.
Oh, that fit in that. Yo!
Oh, yes.
We made it, guys. We've got our own dressing room.
The Coke!
Oh, that's mine, because I did order normal Coke.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm budgeting it for the pizza.
Okay.
Oh.
No, I'm only
bringing my clothes in here.
Oh.
Whoa.
Oh,
my baby. What? That was crazy.
I felt that in
that
my
was, heart. Really that went through me.
That was cold.
Okay.
Good decision. As long as you don't knock anything over.
Yeah, yeah.
This is setting in now. Surely it's setting in.
Saturday. I mean, we've not played live in 4 months, but God knows, God only knows how it's gonna go, to quote some men from the beach. But I don't know. I don't think nervous is the right word. I'm excited, and it's not a dread. It's just kind of a. I don't even know what I'm nervous about, because I'm not really that scared of messing up. Because as the front guy, I feel like. When we've messed up before, which is quite rare to be fair. And if it is, like, you know, like people, the guys will come and be like, oh, I think I messed up, and I'll mess up occasionally, but I don't think it's ever that noticeable. Because we never like mess up structures or anything. It's always just like a missed note or something. And that never really causes much of a stir. But I think if anything ever goes wrong, we just laugh it off. Or at least I try to behind it. It's kind of a mask to my dismay and fear and scaredness of what's just occurred.
How do we like go in?
How do you
need to hold it? I need to have a glass of water when we get in.
Yeah. You had like a big glass of water.
This is so crazy.
This must feel so sick for you lot.
Man. It does, yeah.
I'll tell you, it does feel sick.
I never get nervous. No, joking. Yeah, I am in that. It's like a big show, like a first big show. But I think we all know the songs well enough to not mess up. I won't mess up. I know Isaac might, but that's okay. No one's perfect, so.
Guess what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I mean, I've only played 2 gigs with these guys so far. So I think that doesn't help anything. The third one's going to be like this big, important venue for us. But I'm not too worried. We've been practicing, you know. As long as, like, James doesn't mess it all up, we should be okay.
Right, we're going down. I'm just going to
fix it. Oh,
yeah.
No.
There you go. We'll be doing that with our DVD.
Top 5
Wait, wasn't it the weekend recovery?
3 months, man. And then, yeah, it's good.
3 months? What are you talking about, bro?
3 months of waiting for this.
You nervous yet still?
Yes.
Yeah. What do you mean nervous?
Walking out on stage is the
usual. Usually people ask me, are you nervous?
What's the next day?
150.
Oh, yes. Actually. People are coming like people last, yeah.
Oh, let's go.
Should
we go now, though?
We never do.
What time is it?
It's
Ollie, do you want to take
this
one?
This is our 25th gig, but it's the biggest one so far. We're
high. It's 7:52.
8:02.
I put my phone in charge.
I think the majority of people
are
coming early.
Isaac's just set. One of them's
mine, yeah. I've got
my. Oh, my days.
Levitation.
Such a good night. The buzz that we had coming back off stage and just talking in the dressing room after was so much fun.
We did it. We fucking did it. That's what we actually did it. No, I was going for it, bro. It was so sick. It was my favourite gig ever.
Yeah.
It was just one of the best times. I actually can't believe how well it went. I mean, usually when you build up to something for that long, there's always something that goes wrong.
we got unlimited access.
Yeah, bro.
Do I just leave my bag?
Leave personal stuff up here. Okay. Like anything you don't want, like taking back.
It's strange that when it all finishes, you're kind of left feeling quite empty and not really knowing where to go next, but I'm sure a direction will appear soon.
My sister's coming to watch me, so she'll be suitably trying to disassociate herself.
No! Go! Just take a video!
Yeah, I've been filming, yeah.
I love the Levitation for life. Follow them on Instagram, Spotify.